Hey guys, welcome back to Olympuscraft SMP. Today is going to be a bit of a bittersweet episode because I have a bit of a non-fiction story to tell you guys for a change, and it is about my cats. So, you guys may know this guy, Basil, the orange tabby. He is actually based off of my real-life cat, while Eerie right here, who we pranked Steercat with last episode, is a fictional character and part of the Skult, because of course we would have a mischievous cat in the Skult. But anyway, Basil is actually not the only real-life cat that I had. I actually had another cat named Lola, who unfortunately very recently passed away, and I wanted to take this episode to honor her. And the reason that I don't have her likeness in mob form on this server is because there isn't really a cat in the game that looks like her. You know, Basil, he's a pretty straightforward orange guy, but, you know, Lola, she looked like a dairy cow, and unfortunately Minecraft doesn't really have those, so I wanted to do something a little bit different for her in honor of her memory, because, you know, a lot of people have a lot of misconceptions about cats. You know, they think that they're all mean, that they're all selfish, but Lola was the complete opposite of that. She was an absolute sweetheart, and all she ever wanted was love. You know, you could whip out the treat bag and Basil would come running for the food, but Lola would just want pets. Although, you know, the treats were always a nice bonus. But what she really wanted was to be petted, because she just did not have a nice home before she came to live with us, and we gave her for 7 years everything that she had ever wanted. You know, she would only ever come around for cuddles and pets, and, you know, she was just nice to everybody. And I mean, what else is there to say, really? You know, she was a fighter, she was very strong, even when she got sick, and I just wanted to honor her with this. So that cat statue that's been in the mansion for the past forever long, I have changed to look like Lola. So it is no longer a tuxedo cat, it is now in Lola's likeness. So this is my tribute to her, one of my furry fiends and my best buddies. So I have taken the white nose and made it pink, because she always had the brightest pink nose. And the cat is also mostly white now, but I did keep some of the black around for the cow spots that she had. And unfortunately, I can't really get a good look at this thing because it's in kind of a tight space, but it looks more like her than anything else that I could get. So I even added some little sideburns, because she was a long-haired cat, you know, she was very fluffy, and, you know, I wanted to make some of the the fluffiness visible. But yeah, she was also quite asymmetrical, so different sides, different spots, but yeah, and also the tail is now fully black. But, you know, that's really it for the little monument. I just wanted to do something nice for her that, you know, I haven't done for Basil. But fun fact, both of them were on the Unknown Empire map, or rather the Esten map, in Palartica. So if anyone goes back to watch that, you know, you'd see Basil in the bedroom of Palartica, whereas Lola was in the lobby, and she was actually a Siamese cat on that map, because that was just the closest I could get to her at the time. But yeah, I mean, she was just the absolute best, and I will miss her very much. She is happy now, and she has been happy, and that is really all I could hope for. And knowing her, she would not want me to be sad, because let's face it, I've been sad enough. So I am celebrating her memory with that little statue up there. And because Basil always made sure to take care of Lola in her times of need, I'm going to swap him with Eerie here and take him to the little monument so that they can be together once again And there we have it. The best buddies are reunited, Basil and Lola. So, as he always did, he will continue to watch over her, and I guess she will now watch over him too. So, yeah, this has been a bit of a bittersweet episode, like I said. You know, it's sad that she's gone. You know, she was more than just a pet to me. She was a part of my family and was always there for me when no one else was, just like Basil. But she would not want us to be sad, because she always did her best to try and make me happy. So today we honor that memory and everything that she did for me. Really, that's all I wanted to do for this episode, just a little dedication. In addition to that though, I did manage to get a couple of pumpkin guys like I do every Halloween. Not very many, there's literally just two, but these guys are not so much pumpkin soldiers as they are pumpkin prisoners. But yeah, I'm just gonna leave that guy in there. We have one more to visit. This guy is a zombie villager with a pumpkin on his head. I have not had one of these before, mostly because they just look even more ridiculous than the regular ones, but yeah, these are my pumpkin prisoners, I guess. They don't really add anything except, you know, ambiance to the mansion, I guess. With that said, though, I think that's going to be it for this episode. It was very short and unplanned, but I wanted to make some sort of a dedication to Lola, and that was really the primary focus of the episode. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. This is a hard episode to record, not gonna lie, but Lola's finally at peace, and we have loved and honored her today, and that is all she's ever wanted. So yeah, I'm just gonna stay here with the kitties, and I will see you guys another day. Goodbye.